God is the kind of God who will be pleased with one thing we have to offer. It's our thirst. In other words, God isn't pleased with what we can do for him. I mean, he doesn't need what we can do. God has no deficiencies that I might be required to supply. He is complete in himself. He's overflowing with happiness in the fellowship of the Trinity. Guys, he doesn't need us. And with this being said, why do we spend our lives trying to work our way into right standing with God? We spend our lives thinking that if we do enough, he'll be happy with us. Or we spend our lives wondering if we are good enough. And as I mentioned at the beginning, God's pleased with one thing we have to offer. It's our thirst. It's our hunger for him, our dependence on him, our faith in him. I mean, you see the difference? See, I think the bigger issue is this. God cares more about the inward than he does the outward. He cares about the heart. See, the heart never lies. You can have a hard, callous heart and still put out good deeds in service to God, but the humble and the contrite are the ones who please God. Why? Because their heart is broken and desperate for God. This person realizes their need for the Lord. They know they can't go another step without him. And this is why Jesus started his greatest sermon with this line: "Blessed are those who are poor in spirit." In other words, blessed are those who realize they are really broken and needy and spiritually bankrupt in need of a Savior, and that Savior is Jesus. And when you come to this point, you hunger and you thirst for God in a way that is pleasing to him. You see the difference in the posture of hearts? I mean, why do you think Jesus rebuked the ones who looked religious and did all the deeds, but did them with a dark heart? The hypocrites. And he elevated the broken. He elevated the desperate. I mean, Jesus said it, "You blind Pharisees, first wash the inside of the cup and the dish, and then the outside will become clean too." In other words, Jesus is saying, "You want to please me? Be right in my eyes. Come fully surrender to me and allow me to take your heart of stone and give you a new heart, a heart of flesh." I mean, you see the difference? And in order to come hungry and thirsty for God, you need to realize your need for him. And when you realize you need Jesus, you cling to him as your number one treasure. And this is what is pleasing to God. All the works and the deeds, they just become an overflow of your love for him.